Okie dokie, quick. Super simple living. From the 1st of August, all I'm going to riff about is super simple living. Ideally, I would have somewhere where most of the time the vehicle, and even a little hut. With a hut, the vehicle was parked most of the time, and most of the time I was going around by bicycle. But, I mean, now and again, to park up somewhere like this, it's just like paradise. As long as you don't look at the litter. Park so that I can't see the litter. But, right, your average viewer, reader, is going to think, yeah, but it's about bodily functions, etc. To get down here, 2 months ago, I began speaking with somebody, a woman, 65-year-old, happened to be American, but had spent time in Britain. And a year prior, I had assisted her relocating to Europe. I'd arranged. It was going to be mutual benefit. But I'd arranged for free accommodation for a few months for her with an acquaintance of mine. He needed a company, a companion. She's spiritual. No. She couldn't do the mutual benefit side. Always found reasons. Anyway, but I kind of left her aside for 6 months. Then I was thinking, okay, well, she's based in Glastonbury. We'd had a brief chat about her finding some other area, so I liaised with her. How about we encounter one another again? I'll give you a ride down here and try and introduce you to one or two people. For her benefit. I didn't even like this woman. We had some reasonable conversations. But here's the point. Okay, there's three things in the front of this. Now, in 10 minutes, that will be completely cleared into the back. But first things first. I'll stop doing that. Right, this absurd thing that's taken over Britain the last 10 or 15 years. Of hydration. Now, I get up at 5:30 every morning and my health is bang on. Except for a period when I think I'd been, my body had been buggered by long-term exposure to an extremely damp, mouldy old place. I didn't realise how it would affect me. Anyway, hydration. Now, I'd collected a few small plastic bottles, and I used to keep them in the pocket, or they were kept in that pocket. Now, you don't need to be hydrated during the day. This is just an absurdity that has complicated everybody's life. Like, here's our 15-pound water bottle. It's absurd. Anyway, I'm going to put those away. Back to the woman. So yeah, a couple of months ago, I spent another 5-10 hours of my life speaking with her, suggesting her to research certain people here she might be able to link up with for her spiritual mentor. Of course, they always complicate it. Anyway, somebody's coming super quick. And we were meant to be liaising, sharing the petrol to come down. Mutual benefit. I said, I got a tent in the back, which I do. I discovered over a week all the conversation was a waste of time. She had not researched campsites. It was all charming, as usual, weird bullshit. And as I was driving down, I said to her, look, there's hardly any signal. Can you just give me a couple of lines of direction to meet with you? I think it was the Premier Inn we were going to meet. And I get 7 pages of websites sent into my phone. I mean, this is somebody who sells herself as a true community facilitator, bridger between damaged people. I don't believe one word of it. Anyway, that's her life. But I also sent her a message saying, look, I haven't had time to go to the cheap shops. Oh yeah, this was just, I'd been to a hay festival for a few days. Not to go to the festival, merely to look and see if I could PR my really good material on Super Simple Living. So I sent her a message saying, yeah, just can you grab a bag of nutritious good food, because won't have time to find the best shopping opportunities for a few days. What has she come up with? Included in the bag is like these things, the most impractical things ever if you're living, traveling, existing in a small van. Just off with the fairies. But she welched on a clear deal. I will divert to you 1 hour of fuel back and forth to you. And I'm doing that, then we then share the travelling petrol diesel down here. No, Welsh. Yes. They all do the same. Oh, but your energy's on this. No, love. I've been speaking with you at great length about the logistical economics of you being based down here, which she said, oh, the runes had been telling me, yes, down here is definitely the place I need to be thinking about setting myself up as some kind of a life coach, mentor, whatever. And then, she welshes on it. So it's like, well, she cost me money. She cost me £30 diverting over to hers and loitering there for a couple of days while she went through her usual, she'd call herself partially shamanic bullshit. But, so I had these, like, stowed away for a while. And then eventually I ran out of soap. And the point being, I keep these here. When I'm using these now, and it's like, when I use them, it's like, I put them in a little doodah. It's like, okay, I made the most out of every little word of her bullshit. I shall use those pieces of soap. Now, next to them, of course, one doesn't want to be seen or thought of always as this kind of homespun little person with his thermos flask. Occasionally, I might be parked up in a small town or whatever. What the hell's that? Oh, bloody military. Right, and I think, okay, I want to seem like I'm a middle-class bourgeoisie, one of the hipster travelling Sybarites. Guess what I do? So my flask is there. I have some coffee cups. Now everything in here is exactly in the same place always. But I have so if I wanted to sit in a square and look like I'm, I don't really think like this, but just occasionally, seem like a kind of well-off, visiting, passing through, bohemian, whatever person, I might fill that with my homemade coffee, which is just as nice as theirs, and say £3 or £2.50, and I will appear to be just like all the rest of them, a lifestyle, visiting, travelling person. But even more important than that, I mentioned in a previous video, 2 days ago I think, small things, finding the small things. This is, and the important thing is it's got red on it. That is the little thing that goes in if I want to plug in my
income scales, but also there was just a massive
Excel keyboard. And it had dropped. I couldn't find it. So that's why I'm doing a clean out. But the pleasure at finding this small thing. It's got red on it, so I see it easily. Because the most important thing, when you pull off, it's always to look around. Has anything dropped out? So, because it's got red on it, I will see it if it's dropped out. Now, yep, this looks a disgusting mess. In 5 minutes exactly, it'll be all clean, ship shape. Now, hello you. Travelling with animal on board, because I know it's going to be cooler for 3 or 4 days, and it's theoretically summer. If it's hot, use dry fuel, because it won't get smelly. If it's chilly, I'm going to go onto a can of, it's out somewhere, meaty food for it. I'll get it in a minute.
Hello.
Right. That's it. It'll be all sorted out in 5 minutes exactly. But it's all about keeping it to the absolute. You see, if you keep your life to the absolute most simple setting, look at it. Raining mid-afternoon, got up very early this morning. Point being, when it rains, I love the sea.